Hello, today we're gonna create a timer inside Tasker. We're gonna work with tasks, of course, and also with scenes. So first of all, let's see what we are creating today. I've placed a shortcut on my home screen. Here is my shortcut. Let's click on that and you will see a pop-up of a scene, and I can put the hours, the minutes and the seconds. When I click on the seconds, for example, and I put here 7 seconds and I click on save, let's see what it does. So that's quite easy. So you saw a window popping up on my screen, and we have also in our notification bar here a notification from the timer, and the timer is finished. So that's what we are creating. For this case, I've put a shortcut on the home screen, but I can also trigger that by using auto voice. For example, I can say set a timer at 6 minutes and it will do the same. Let's see how we can do that inside Tasker. Let's open Tasker, and here I have my Tasker, and you see I have 2 tasks and only 1 scene. So that's all you need for creating this. So the first thing you need to know is to work with scenes, of course. So let's open that scene and I will explain what everything's going on. So let's open that, and you see my scene. I've placed an icon on the left, I've placed a text also here. The hours is also text, the minutes is also a text, the seconds also, and then we have 2 buttons, save and cancel. And we have also 3 text edit fields. The important things is the 3 text edit fields and also the 2 buttons. That's the most important. So for now on, let's see what the first text edit field does. If you don't know how to create a text edit field, just click on the plus and then go down and you will see here text edit field. Click on that and then you can create something like I've done. So for this example, I'm going back and let's open the first text edit field. It's quite simple. The name is text edit 1. You can change that. The important thing inside this is the text changed. So I'm here and I'm using a variable set. Let's open that. And you see timer hours to new val. What's happening here? When I change the value inside that field, it will save it in another variable, timer hours. That's all what it does. And then I can use timer hours in other tasks as well. I hope you understand that. That's very important. So the new value you have put inside that text box is gonna move inside timer hours. Let's go back, and that's all you need to do. The minutes is just the same as you see. Here, timer minutes to new val, and the second also, timer seconds to new val. Okay, that's very easy. Now, the save button and the cancel button. Let's open the save button. The save button, we have only UI tab and long tab. And what's interesting for us is the tab, of course. What's gonna happen when I click on that button? Gonna click on tap and it will perform a task, set timer to task, for example. That's all what it is. Let's go back, and then the cancel button. When I click on that, also on tap, we have several commands. The first thing we need to do is clear the variable timer hours, clear the variable timer minutes, clear the variable timer seconds. And then we destroy our scene overlay timer tut. Remember, destroying a scene is not deleting a scene from your phone, but closing the scene. You have also hide scene, but when you hide a scene, it's still active in the background. So when you use destroy scene, you can completely close the scene, okay? And that's all you need to do for creating that scene. Let's go back to our tasks. And the first task is simple opening our scene. So when I click on that, we see show scene and we use overlay timer tut. That's the name of the scene and we display it as dialogue, as you see here. Also, I would suggest you should use the magnifying glass for finding the right name of your scene. And also I've changed it here in the vertical position up and not to center, but you can change that as you want. Let's go back. And that was the first task. The second task is a little bit more complicated, but not so complicated if you know how to work with variables. So let's open the second one. And when we open that, you will see here an if statement, an if statement, an if statement, and then some other actions as well. So the first if statement is if timer hours isn't set. In other words, if the variable timer hours is empty. Let's open that. You will see if timer hours is empty, we're gonna set timer's hours to 0. Okay, and then we close the if statement with an and if. The second one is just the same, but for the minutes. So we have here, if timer minutes isn't set, we're gonna set it to 0. And then the same for second, of course. So if timer seconds isn't set, we're gonna set it to 0. Okay, then we're gonna destroy our scene because we clicked on the save button. The next thing we wanna do is pop up. And what should it say? The timer is set on the variable timer hours, or variable timer minutes, minutes, variable timer seconds, seconds. Go back and then we're gonna wait. Normally when you use a wait command, you have to put some numbers inside it. So let me explain that. When I click on plus and I click on task, and then we're gonna use the wait command. We have here a slider and you can change the milliseconds, the seconds, the minutes, etc., etc. But you have also here a double arrow. When you click on that, you can place a variable inside that. So let's go back. Okay, we're back inside our task. Let's open that wait command for now. And we're gonna use for the seconds, the variable timer seconds, for the minutes timer minutes, and for the hours timer hours. Let's go back. And then we're gonna use a notify, and the notify is the text and the icon you saw in the notification bar. Let's open that again. You saw here the timer is finished and the title is timer, and I've used the standard icon from Tasker, but you can choose your own. Okay, let's open that. Here you see timer, the text is timer finished. You can choose your own icon and that's all you need to do. Let's go back. After we flashed our notification inside our notification bar, we play a ringtone. In my case, I have a notification sound called musical alarm. So when I click on that, I'm gonna use the notification sounds and the stream also as notification. You can change that if you want to use the volume of the ringtone, the alarm, etc., etc. Let's go back. And then we're gonna use a pop-up, and inside our pop-up we have here the timer is finished like you have set. That's all. And then we use 3 times the variable clear. We're gonna clear the variable timer hours, clear the variable timer minutes and the seconds. And I have to remove the last action because I've created that just for explaining the wait command action here. So when I long press on that and cut that, it's gone. Okay, and that's my whole task. And when you have done that, you can place an icon on that. If you don't know how to do that, click on your test and you will see here on the right place an icon. When you click on that, you can choose some icons stored locally on your phone or built-in icons as well. So that's all you need to do for creating that task. So I hope you found this interesting, and if you have any comments, you can leave those on my Google page. Thank you.